These results are, again, ahead of expectations. So what's driven this?
Well, I think the key measures are in the right direction. So valuation up, revenue profit up, vacancy rate down, and gearing lower. But if I was to pick three things, it would be success in leasing space to our customers, which has brought down vacancy rates to just 3.4%. Those lettings have been ahead of rental value estimates, and developments have again been a driver of the valuation with strong performance from our developments.
Strong performance. You've outperformed the market benchmark for the portfolio as a whole, but you've underperformed for certain business areas. So why is that?
Well, our outperformance overall is down to the developments that I've talked about and also the mix of our portfolio with a big exposure to London, both London offices and London retail. In each of the segments, London offices we were a little below, but then our outperformance is likely to come when we do key development lettings. London retail again down a bit, but remember last year we were over 12% ahead of the benchmark. Retail warehouses pretty much in line, and shopping centres ahead.
And Martin, turning to the financials in more detail, what's driving the revenue profit growth?
Well, the revenue profit growth is down to two things. There was an increase in net rental income, and that was primarily on the back of £13 million of non-recurring items. But also, revenue profit grew because our net interest cost declined. It declined by some £11.2 million over the 6 months.
But with such relatively low voids, where will future revenue growth come from?
Well, low voids is a good starting point for rental growth. But if we look at our five-year plan, actually the majority of our earnings growth will come from the developments that we're producing at the moment and getting a good high yield on cost from those.
And so what's the implication for revenue profit for the second half of the year?
Well, I think we'll see revenue profit in the second half come off, as I think it's highly unlikely that we'll see the same level of non-recurring items that we did in the first half. I think net rental income may also reduce slightly as we empty out certain properties in advance of redevelopment. On the net interest cost side, however, I would expect that benefit to flow through into the second half of the year.
Earnings are up around 16%. The dividend is up less than 3%. So shouldn't you have passed more of this increase on to shareholders?
Well, there's a couple of points to make. The first is that this is a half year. And what we do for our quarterly dividends is we reflect the final dividend from last year. That was up by just under 3%, and so we followed that through into the first two quarters this year. But I think it's important to recognise that dividends and dividend growth are about our medium-term outlook, not about a six-month period which included some non-recurring items.
And you said that you have enough balance sheet capacity to fund new acquisitions, but you've also said that the credit market, the risks are increasing. So what will you do if you can't negotiate new facilities?
Well, let me just explain what our facilities are. We've got £1.5 billion of revolving credit facilities that have a legal maturity of August 2013, and then we have some bilateral facilities, £700 million of those, that mature in 2014. And in total, we're only drawn at just over £400 million. So I think it's important to put it into context. But more importantly, we will be able to put in place new facilities. I'm confident that they'll be sufficient for our requirements. And we also have access to the bond market with our AA rating.
Your statement seems more cautious on London developments with regard to occupier take-up. So what's your thinking here?
Well, I think there is data in the market which shows that levels of take-up in 2011 are more muted than in 2010. But interestingly, what we are seeing is large corporates who need to move are recognising that they have little choice. So we think the appetite for the relatively small number of new buildings that are being delivered continues to be good.
And more specifically, what's the prospect for the leasing of 20 Fenchurch Street and your other committed schemes?
Well, we've seen since the summer of this year actually an increase in the number of inquiries on our committed development schemes. So we have live inquiries for all of 20 Fenchurch Street, 123 Victoria Street and 62 Buckingham Gate.
And what about Old Bailey, Victoria Circle, Arundel Great Court? When will these schemes be brought forward?
Well, Arundel Great Court and Victoria Circle, we don't even get vacant possession till towards the end of 2012. We'll make decisions close to that time. Ludgate and Old Bailey is being demolished at the moment, and we will make a decision within the next couple of months as to whether we press the button or wait for a pre-let or perhaps pause a little bit, as we've done successfully in the past with Park House. But we are encouraged by pre-letting discussions.
Your performance in retail looks slightly counterintuitive to the doom and gloom we're seeing in the newspapers over consumer sentiment, for example. So can you explain how you're achieving that?
In very broad terms, it's that we're providing the space that retailers want. So if you look at our retail warehouse portfolio, we're able to produce larger units, and those are generally let to the stronger, larger occupiers. And then if you look at the shopping centre portfolio, we know the customers very well, we're able to deliver them the size of units that they want, and we can be flexible on the types of leases we offer.
I think it's a bit about people and property. We aspire to do better than national trends in retail, so we have great relationships with the major retailers, and we have a high quality portfolio. And you are seeing an increasing divergence between poor and average retail property and really good quality retail properties. You can see it in the vacancy rates, 12 to 13% nationally, 3 to 4% on the best portfolios.
And voids were down significantly in the period, but we do have the crucial Christmas period coming up. So what are your expectations for insolvencies after Christmas?
Well, there are always insolvencies in retailing, and the period after Christmas is often the most challenging time. In our announcement today, we have said that we expect insolvencies to increase. But with our high quality portfolio and the low level of voids, we think we're reasonably well placed.
You've achieved £8.9 million worth of lettings at good rental levels in the period. But what kind of incentives are you having to offer?
Well, in shopping centres, it's around 12 months, and that's no change on previous periods. If we look at retail warehousing, it is up a little there, but that is largely because we give longer leases.
And Francis, you've made good progress on your out-of-town development initiative. But again, is this really the right time to be investing in further retail development?
Absolutely. You'll have picked up that the stronger retailers are prudently taking more space to grow profits. And we are responding to that demand. And we are prudently delivering those additional units on a pre-let basis to drive our returns.
And Buchanan Street is progressing well, but Leeds doesn't look to have moved forward much in leasing terms.
Well, the pattern of lettings and pre-lettings on big shopping centre developments is quick, slow, quick. So early on, you get the big retailers who commit to pre-lettings. You then tend to get a quieter period, 2 years or so out from completion. And then in the run-up to opening, you get a rush of lettings. So actually, we are bang on the plan that we set for pre-lettings at Leeds.
Francis, you haven't made any major acquisitions this year. So what has to change for you to take advantage of the opportunities that might arise?
Well, there have been a few comments in the press. We have actually bid on more properties in the last 3 months. To date, we haven't been successful. I'm relaxed about that because we're prepared to be patient. We're going to stay disciplined on pricing. I do think we're seeing a bit of a shift on the balance between buyers and sellers. And I think you will see us making a number of acquisitions which are accretive to earnings and accretive to total return.
And Francis, you've been very consistent about your outlook for the property market. So you say it's challenging. Does it still feel like a ripple?
Well, we said exactly 2 years ago we didn't see absolutely straight line growth in the recovery in property markets. We said we thought there were still some residual financial imbalances which might cause a ripple. The sense I have at the moment is conditions are changeable and they're uncertain. And some aspects are attractive, like very low risk-free rate of return on government bond yields. Other aspects are more challenging. I think we are extremely well positioned on a range of scenarios. Our balance sheet gearing is low. We have low vacancy rates within the portfolio, and we have some optionality on some of our potential future projects.